Hi there, just a quick announcement before I begin this video. I've reopened my Patreon page for my League content, so if you like to support my League videos, then please consider becoming a patron, and in future videos, patrons will be showcased at the end of every video, and you guys can also vote on what my next Why No One Plays should be. Anyways, welcome back to another episode of Why No One Plays. It's a series where I discuss champions in League of Legends that rarely see much play, if any at all, in both the pro scene and solo queue, especially recently. Since League is a constantly evolving game for better or worse, there might be times where certain champions have a high pick or ban rate that spans a patch or two, but overall the game does remain relatively consistent on which champions remain popular and which ones don't. For this episode, let's talk about Vel'Koz. After 4 years, he's finally gotten another skin, and probably the best one he's ever gotten. Granted, there's not really much to compare it to, but whatever, you get the idea. Following standard procedure, let's just start with a disclaimer before we get into anything else. This series is not meant to bash a champion and say they're bad or troll, nor to discourage anyone from playing them. If anything, I encourage you to give them a try. Additionally, for anyone who does play and or main the champion in question, my intent behind Why No One Plays is not to hate on your main. Rather, just to create discussion over possible reasons as to why certain champions don't see as loyal or wide of a following as others. With that said, if you enjoy these types of videos, make sure to leave a rating, it'd be much appreciated, and also subscribe for more Why No One Plays. There should be a playlist in the description below if you want to check out any other episodes, and if this is your first time joining, check out my sister series, which is Why Everyone Plays, in which I kind of cover champions that are the opposite of these, where they're really popular instead of very obscure. Anyways, that aside, let's just get into the video. While he's not nearly as irrelevant as the likes of the previous champion I cover, Yorick, Vel'Koz is not a common mage to see in a game. He maintains a consistent play rate of 4-6% and never really drops under a 50% win rate. Those stats would be good, relatively speaking, but in the same sort of predicament as Kog'Maw, Vel'Koz has never been able to jump into the limelight, like, ever. In fact, since his release in 2014, he's never had a pick rate above 10%, not even for a patch or two, which is atypical since even super unpopular champions go up to at least like 15-20% for a month or two. However, despite his unimpressive numbers, Vel'Koz as a champion is in a very healthy state in terms of his status and, you know, whether his kit is overpowered or not, and so this video, I will speak more positively about him as a champion, but then I'll touch on why he's doomed to never see a double-digit pick rate. Mages are divided into three categories, and the categories consist of Artillery Mage, Battle Mage, and Burst Mage. I talked about this already in my Heimerdinger video, I think, so if you want to learn a bit more, just a footnote, if this is your first time watching, a lot of concepts I talk about in these videos are explained in more detail in videos I've made before that are the first to touch on that type of champion. Naturally, the longer the series goes on, the less exposition I want to give because I hate repeating myself, and I'm sure you do too. Anyways, if it wasn't obvious to you before, Vel'Koz fits into the Artillery Mage category, and while he does boast some impressive burst damage for his type, his weapon of choice in combat is poking, constantly lobbing damage towards opposing champions until they're forced to retreat or get low enough for you to lay down your full combo and destroy them altogether. Here's the thing, of the three mage classes, Artillery not only has the smallest roster, but it's also the least popular category in the game via pick rate. Aside from Vel'Koz, there are only two other champions in the game that are exclusively poke mages, Xerath and Ziggs, who also don't have the most impressive popularity history relative to their peers, despite all three of them being not too shabby in their own right. His lack of play rate stems from an external element of the game, and that's the community's overall outlook on the game, and even Riot's own design philosophy changing over the years. Putting it bluntly, Vel'Koz has and will always have a low pick rate because he is a dying archetype. Now to get into the focus of this argument, let me quickly deconstruct his abilities because they're pretty fair and great from a design perspective. Organic Deconstruction is his passive, which is a 3-pointer. Casting 3 separate instances of ability damage on a single target will deal a burst of true damage with really nice scaling. It does solid damage early, middle, and late game, and it ramps up much higher as you go along. Because his passive has no cooldown on target, he can reactivate it over and over and over again, which could result in thousands of true damage on a target alone. His basic attacks do prevent the stacks from wearing off, but 7 seconds is a very long time in a League game, so that's kind of icing on the cake. Onto his bread and butter, Plasma Fission. It's one of the best designed skill shots in my opinion. Vel'Koz shoots out a bolt of energy that bisects and travels in opposite directions, perpendicularly from the initial target line. It deals magic damage and slows any target hit for a substantial amount. At max rank, it lasts over 2.5 seconds. And yes, if you have any basic understanding of geometry, whether or not you had the Pythagorean theorem drilled into your head throughout all of middle school, that means you can boost your maximum range by angling the shot to go across the hypotenuse instead, or diagonal. Now, before you laugh at how nerdy that sounds, it's a big deal. Plasma Fission can travel 1.5 times further if you shoot it in that direction, so don't discount the importance of understanding mathematics with this guy. Void Rift cuts a straight line in the target direction that deals damage, and then after a short delay, it detonates, dealing more damage. Similar to Victor's Death Ray, although not nearly as powerful, but for good reason. Even if you land both hits of Vel'Koz's W, it doesn't have the most impressive AP ratio or base damage for an ability with a very long cooldown, but what makes this so good is that Vel'Koz can use it twice in quick succession, since you can store two charges of Void Rift, which then equals out to a potential 550 plus 80% AP magic damage. On top of that, Void Rift applies organic deconstruction stacks twice, one for the first wave and another for the detonation, so you have even more damage coming on after that. Moving on, Tectonic Disruption, which functions similar to Cho'Gath's Rupture, it designates a target location to explode and knock up or knock back enemies based on how close the explosion is to Vel'Koz. Pretty unimpressive base damage and AP ratio otherwise, but if you notice by now, aside from perhaps his Q, Vel'Koz's general kit doesn't sport the highest damage or AP ratios. In fact, they're kind of below average. Vel'Koz is designed as a poke champion, but he actually feels more like a mid-range mage because while any other poke champion like Ziggs or Xerath have most of their damage done through stray shots here and there, Vel'Koz requires you to combo your attacks in strings to do the most amount of damage because Plasma Fission is his only basic ability that extends beyond 1200 units. Lastly, his ultimate, Lifeform Disintegration Ray, a massive laser that does huge damage to all targets caught within the beam. You can also rotate the laser along your cursor during the channel. One cool thing is that if a target has recently been hit by his passive, the ultimate does true damage, and at max rank you can very well receive over 2000 if you tank the entire laser. Because of its long range and generously wide hitbox, this is one of the best teamfight ultimates to use in a choke point like the jungle. While it's a lot of magic damage on its own, the goal is to deconstruct targets with your basic abilities to prime Lifeform Disintegration Ray to do true damage. Normally, in most circumstances, that can amount to about double the total damage you would do because 100 magic resist means you only deal 50% of the total damage, and most champions would be close to 70 to 100 MR or higher if you're well into the mid game. So all of Vel'Koz's abilities have their definitive functions, and he's got some very impressive damage output. Unlike other poke champions, his attacks can be used both defensively and offensively, since Plasma Fission can kite enemies just as easily as he can poke, while Tectonic Disruption knocks enemies away if they're right next to you. So, he's not as much of a sitting duck in regards to his vulnerabilities, yet why does he have such a low pick rate if overall he's got no real problem to his design? Two reasons. One, he's a very technical champion, which means a lot of his power is locked behind a rather high learning curve, but it comes also with much less satisfaction. Satisfaction is paramount for us as players and humans because you want to feel the sense of accomplishment mastering a champion, or any other part in life for example. If you were to practice something, you want to have some sort of reward factor that comes with it to gratify you based on how much effort you put in. And while Vel'Koz can land some pretty nasty game-winning plays, as a champion his actions aren't very attention-grabbing relative to some other explosive champions such as Lee Sin and Darius. It's mostly because poke champions by nature are punishers, in that they wait for the enemy team to make a mistake rather than initiate themselves. In a sense, he's a very subdued champion. You get a lot out of your results, but not all that much applause behind it. Vel'Koz takes a lot of patience to play, waiting for the right opportunity to come to you rather than creating the opportunities yourself. However, if we compare Vel'Koz to his fellow poke mages Ziggs and Xerath, he may have the lowest effective range of the three, but he boasts the highest burst. Naturally, Xerath and Ziggs prioritize throwing random shots here and there and picking people off from afar, but Vel'Koz is at his best when fighting enemies in mid-range combat, especially in teamfights where he can kite around a fight and prime his ultimate. He's less mechanically demanding, but is more methodically demanding. He has a huge skill floor in terms of game knowledge because you have to understand when to shift between steady attrition and an outright full combo. If we combine his strategical difficulty along with the need to be less of a general on the battlefield and more of a tactician planning out moves on a chessboard, it doesn't really match everyone's cup of tea. Which smoothly transitions to point number 2. Poke champions are generally not favorable in solo queue because they encourage attrition and siege, both very patient and methodical in terms of winning, whereas in solo queue, people just prefer to attack anything that moves. If you recall back to when I explained why Kog'Maw's starting to fall against the test of time, Vel'Koz is sort of the same. In fact, all poke champions are slowly feeling the adverse effects of the game's evolution. As you already know, Riot's been making a desperate push to make champions that are all about cool and flashy plays. Just about any new champion and every new rework in the game has built-in mobility. Kai'Sa, Qiyana, Pyke, Yone, Sett, Sylas, there are far more champions being released with much higher mobility and game tempo than ever before. And even if Riot makes a champion without necessarily a blink or a dash, like Senna, Lilia, and Aphelios, they still come with some form of movement speed burst or some tool that allows them to self-peel at a moment's notice, generally requiring almost no setup. Zoe may be considered a poke champion, but for all intents and purposes, I see her as more of a burst. There hasn't been an artillery specialist in League of Legends for over 30 champions. Players do not like playing or playing against this subclass because it devolves into long drawn-out games where poke champions might be able to get the enemy team down a few pegs, but maybe not enough to finish the job, while the enemy team can't engage because they're under heavy fire. Additionally, it makes for just very poor spectator sport. You have to remember that while solo queue is the main essence of the game, Riot spends a lot of their resources and wherewithal catering to the pro scene. After all, they do make a lot of capital from the professional league, tournaments, and sponsors. So understandably, it is in their best interest to make League of Legends as enjoyable to watch as possible. Subsequently, artillery champions have become sort of a dying class since they're at their best, where both teams are playing a snowball fight rather than mixed martial arts. Which one would you rather watch? That's not to say poke mages aren't viable, they still are, but in a time period of League of Legends where champions and players alike are becoming increasingly faster, more aggro, impatient as hell, and prefer to have explosive teamfights instead of slow, patient wars of attrition, it makes sense why you would never really see them all that much. As sad as it may sound, people would much rather just play someone like Syndra, Swain, or Karthus who have much less effective range, but way more immediate action in a teamfight. Should anything be done to change this? Absolutely not. I think he's perfectly fine as a champion. In fact, I very much like his design and gameplay. It's just simply another one of those cases where no one plays a champion, not because they're weak or because they have some dumb gimmick that's annoying to play around. It's just that they're kind of boring. In Season 10, everyone just wants to go guns blazing into the middle of an enemy fight. Doesn't even matter if you're super squishy anymore. Case in point, Samira. That's the entire community's idea of a fun champion built into one package. Truthfully, I don't think we'll ever really have a poke meta for as long as League lives. Everything's just getting faster and faster, games are ending sooner and sooner. League is looking like less of a chess game and more of a first-person shooter, that's just how it is. But I think that's enough to wrap it up for this video. Apologies for rambling so much, I feel bad for all the champions I've covered that never have their moment to shine by no fault of their own, but rather just community sentiment. And there's no easy solution to rework the champion without just completely shredding their identity. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below of your opinions of Vel'Koz, either positive or negative. And to all the Vel'Koz mains out there, I would really appreciate it if you can tell me what your sentiments are on this, because I'm sure there's a lot you have to say about this guy. By all means, if you feel like I've understood something about the champion incorrectly, feel free to correct me on it. But be sure to check out my playlist on other champions that no one plays in the video description, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more League videos like this. But for now, that's going to be it. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you again soon for the next video. Take care.